It's a gift that goes on giving. There will be more, and it seems to me we still haven't had the whole story, and these things feed it on themselves. And also, it's more interesting than going over and over and over again, a subject which has been discussed pretty much without limit now for several months. It's a diversion from that, and obviously the personal alleged wrongdoings of one not particularly attractive human being, and the chance, say, at the end of it, of collecting a scalp, will keep it going. And unless the government can throw something very new into the arena fairly soon, it could keep going long beyond the old Alistair Campbell rule, which is if something is still going on after 4 days, you've got a problem.
Yes.
If you can't bore them out into something else by then you may actually have to do something. Of course, the New Labour did chuck people to the wolves. Poor old Robin Cook was told, no, choose your wife or your job. David Blunkett was fired. Peter Mandelson was fired. I think they mostly came back to office sooner or later, but they would ultimately chuck people off the sledge if they thought it would suit them, because that's now the process.
But the problem for Boris is that if he allows them to get Cummings, as it were, his entire edifice crumbles, because it's the beginning of the end, isn't it?
I don't think so. I think that people are generally satisfied with these goblets of meat and then go away. That's the sad thing about it for me. What I want is for people to say, isn't it absurd that a senior official in the government is being driven from his job for failing to follow rules which, on any serious account, are ridiculous, and which it increasingly appears did no good at all. And to return to the whole basis of all our discussions, and there's a story in the Times today saying that the people trying to create a vaccine for COVID-19 are having trouble because there aren't enough cases of it now.
Right.
That it actually the disease is actually disappearing, so it's getting harder and harder to make the necessary tests.
Right.
And it is, and it's going through what a number of people have said from the start. There's a normal bell curve of rising, reaching a peak and falling. And I don't think any of the actions which the government took made any substantive difference to that.
And I think
spasm of banning people from seeing close relatives and stopping them from working and shutting down the economy turns out to have been totally futile. Now, that's an important story. That's something for which people should resign. But I'm afraid this concentration on the alleged wrongdoings of Dominic Cummings completely diverts people from the much larger issue.
Yes. Although, I suppose issue...
I think he's not me. He should stay, but he should be exhibited, perhaps with a face mask on, at every subsequent press conference, like a kind of ghost feast to remind people of the ludicrousness of government policy. Keep him.
Yeah, well, I mean, here's the other thing.
Don't get rid of him. And the other thing people don't seem to grasp is if they're trying to do down Dominic Cummings, I would think that within 6 months of him being driven from this job, he'll pop up again, probably in the private sector, in a much better paid job than he has now. So if they think they're doing him any harm, they're very much mistaken.
Yeah, but this is the trouble. It's a sort of hysteria that starts and doesn't end until somebody gets their pound of flesh, as you say, until the raw meat is sort of thrown to the dogs, because they see Dominic Cummings as the enemy. They see him as the man they must get to take him down, because he's so arrogant.
There's one part of this. When people say, look, I wasn't... There's one particular person who said, well, I wasn't able to see my dying father in his last hours, and why did I go through all this if Dominic Cummings can behave like this? Is a very reasonable question to ask.
There's no reason for it, all the
sacrifices which people made because they were corralled and panicked into it by the government. Now do indeed look extremely, but the response to that isn't punish Dominic Cummings. The response to this, why was this policy implemented? Why can it not now be...
But is there not now, Peter...
quickly do something about calling to account the people who got us into this mess.
Yes, but is there...
We say, and I ask you to stay with us, lift up your voices in this great city in the heart of England. Send to all the world a message. England lives and marches on.
God save.